In this video, we are going to look at the Bernese rule for ankle fractures. Get our very own assessment ebook and mobile app. Links are in the video description. Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. If you follow our channel, you are probably familiar with the Ottawa Ankle Rules, which are one of the most famous clinical prediction rules in orthopedic physical assessment. The aim of the rule is to reduce the need for radiographs following an ankle inversion trauma to rule out a fracture of the ankle or midfoot. The Ottawa Ankle Rules are not the only developed CPR for this purpose, though. Among others, the Bernese Ankle Rule has been proposed as an alternative. They use an indirect stress technique to avoid directly palpating the injured regions. Barels et al. In 2017 report a pooled positive likelihood ratio of 3.54 and negative likelihood ratio of 0.39, which is why they have a moderate clinical value in excluding a fracture. The rules are positive and indicate the need for radiography if one of the following steps caused pain. 1. Indirect fibular stress where the malleolar fork is compressed approximately 10 cm proximal to the fibular tip. 2. Direct medial malleolar stress. The thumb is pressed flat on the medial malleolus. 3. Compression stress of the midfoot and the hindfoot. One hand fixes the calcaneus in a neutral position and the other hand applies a sagittal load on the forefoot so that the midfoot and hindfoot are compressed. In the beginning I mentioned the Ottawa Ankle Rules, which you can watch by a click or tap on the left. Now there's just one thing left to do for you, which is hitting that like button and making sure you are subscribed to this channel before you leave so you don't miss out on future uploads. As always, check the links in the video description. This was Andreas for Physiotutors. I'll see you next time. Bye.